A man finds an abandoned plane in the forest. Is this going to be a plane that crashed? The man is full of doubts now, because it's all covered in black paint on the windows of the plane's facade. He couldn't see what's inside the plane, so the man tries to get into the plane. Suddenly, an unprecedented fear comes to the man. There are hundreds of dead human bodies in the plane, and they seem to have been dead for a long time. Hi, I'm D-Class Zero. Today, let's talk about SCP-787, the plane that doesn't exist. SCP-787 is a Boeing 747-200 airliner. The windows on its facade are all covered with black paint. SCP-787 was first found in a woody wilderness in Washington in June 1987. There were 515 dead human bodies inside SCP-787. They were all numbered SCP-787 by SCP Foundation. December 13, 2007. The identity of SCP-787-112 was confirmed. He was a retired optometrist who lived in Atlanta. The man made it clear that he had no accident in June 1987, and claimed that he had never boarded that plane. This information was confirmed by his wife and son. According to the forensic results, the causes of death in SCP-787 were different, including drowning, starvation, burns, stabs, blunt injuries, and so on. However, regardless of the cause of death, all SCP-787 bodies had suffered man-made damage in a certain degree. These included the disappearance of the tongue, skin damage, finger loss, and so on. Although SCP-787 had shown signs of high decay, but in the decades since the Foundation discovered SCP-787, these rotting individuals showed no signs of further decay. Visual shadow or unexplained noise would automatically appear in SCP-787. The abnormal events recorded by the Foundation are as follows. August 1, 1998. On the left side of the SCP-787, there was a sound of hitting the door and window. The process lasted 7 minutes and 15 seconds. But the internal camera didn't find anything during this period. October 6, 1993. The movie screen on the plane suddenly started. It showed a black and white image of a dead male body. Meanwhile, there came a female voice reading gynecology manual in Czech. The process lasted about 43 minutes. July 30, 1997. A blurred human figure appeared in seat H43 and removed the emergency oxygen supplement. The figure put on the breathing mask and stood for 2 minutes and 15 seconds. Then he took off the mask and walked out of the screen, and never appeared on the other cameras. July 30, 2001. A fuzzy human figure about 1 meter high appeared in the plane. The figure sat in the co-pilot's seat for 3 minutes and 50 seconds, and made a soft whimper. Then, the figure vomited and left the cockpit. The Foundation analyzed the vomit. They found that the main components were nitrous oxide, thorium, bird droppings, and 3 human nails. May 5, 2005. A clear female voice could be heard throughout the SCP-787. The content was as follows.
For your comfort and pleasure today, pancakes will now be served. Please don't leave your present seat. Pancakes will now be served. Please don't leave your present seat. Please don't leave your present seat. Please don't leave your present seat.
September 9, 2007. The emergency oxygen supplement in SCP-787 dropped down and retracted. This process repeated 14 minutes and 15 seconds, and there were nearly 20 people's screams in the process. November 29, 2008. The internal temperature of SCP-787 varied from 20 degrees to minus 13 degrees in 19 seconds. The process lasted 10 minutes and 29 seconds, then returned to normal. To investigate the truth of SCP-787, the Foundation had sent some D-class personnel into its internal. In addition to the 515 victims, they finally found a new body in the locker. It was also numbered SCP-787-516 by the Foundation. This was a 30-year-old Indian male. His items were as follows. 3 custom suits. Surgical mask and rubber gloves. No loaded weapons. A box of mints. A folding knife with a woman in the handle. A Horus Eye talisman. The flight record of SCP-787. To the great surprise of SCP Foundation, SCP-787-516 was different from other victims. He doesn't show any decay. No autopsy could reveal the real cause of his death. June 19, 2013. In the last exploration of SCP-787, the researchers found the plane's flight data recorder under Ceta-13. But there was nothing in the recorder, except for a short sentence. "I'm sorry, the Foundation can't explain now why the body of SCP-787-112 is found in SCP-787, and he doesn't know about it. There is a theory that this is a plane from the future. Please write your opinion in the comments. And don't forget subscribe my channel. See you later."